This moment will affect you for the rest of your entire lives. Nothing you have ever experienced in the past will shock as much as this.
Yes, it is all manipulated. This is the worst possible thing you could ever do to yourself if you don't know what you're doing. So, right? You're loving the Yeti. Ooh! Right? You gotta love the Yeti. They make $300 mugs that keep your coffee hot for like a week and a half. $6,000 cooler, right? Oh, Christmas. What a great thing. You can't find your boss something to buy. You're sick of getting them ties. Why don't you get them a $90 mug? Whatever. New IPO. The stock's been good. We belong the stock. We went into the stock and we actually held it into the report. Then the numbers come out. I'm not gonna read the headlines for you, but suffice it to say, every headline was phenomenal. Increasing revenues, EBITDA, analyst upgrades. Everybody's loving the Yeti. I don't give a shit what I'm reading on the internet. The suckers read the internet and they read headlines and they say, wow, look at Yeti with that blowout number. I better buy some at the open. Thanks. I'm selling it to you because I don't care. I'm in the thing from 18 bucks. I'm thanking God that the numbers were good enough that the stock gaps up. Get out. Next thing you know, this thing's tanking. As soon as the market opens up, boom, you're selling the rest. Now you're thinking, holy shit, what the hell's going on? The invalid, the imbecile moron who read Yahoo Finance, and I'm sorry if I'm talking directly to you because I know there's people out there, because winning traders make other traders my victim. You fell to my sword. You read on the internet that Yeti was a good idea to buy, and you bought it not knowing what the hell you were doing, because that's what's called a one-minute multi-day VWAP earnings reversal that has now worked 73 times in a row. 73 times in a row since May. When you got an earnings report, whether it be down, whether it be up, especially when all the headlines are telling you that you should be jacking off. Yeah, look at the Yeti. Doesn't matter. Because you got to remember, there's guys like me who are sitting there thinking, we won. Look at the Yeti. Let's take profits. So the anatomy of this trade on Yeti was that I come in, and I'm not the only one. Obviously, this got 4.3 million shares traded on it today, right? Right? You got the headline. Do I give a shit about the headline? No. I care about what the stock is doing. First thing you want to do, if you held it overnight and it's gapped up the next day, you've won. Take something off the table. Why did you hold it overnight? Because you were hoping it gaps up. Here it is, gapped up. Sell it. I don't give a shit about the headline.
But the earnings, Kenny. The revenues are exploding. Kenny. Or Warlock, whatever you call yourself. The revenues. The EBITDA. The EBITDA, Kenny. The EBITDA. Fuck your EBITDA.
The stock opens up, and within, what are we talking? What are we talking? Four candles? You're getting lit the fuck up. So right there, right before the open, and the reason we trade VWAP around earnings season is because there's a lot more volume, making volume weighted average price that much more important. And by the way, PCG, you can suck my balls. Yeti breaks the VWAP, so I'm selling this thing because I'm a winner. Woo, I can't believe this thing's at 2150. Let's get the hell out here, 2135. And it breaks the VWAP at 2088. Boom, that's it. You're done. You're out of the stock right now. Now you're thinking, all right, let's see if this thing starts to roll over. So then next thing you know, it's rolling over. Within two candles, three candles, four candles, this thing's breaking back under 20 bucks. You've got to be shorting this thing at $20. Are you crazy? PCG, you can eat my ass. This trade right now exemplifies Yeti I'm talking about, not PCG, and I'll get into the PCG trade, but if you show up later in the room, I'll show you the PCG trade. Yeti exemplifies, or let's use a larger word, it's a microcosm. You like that shit, right? Microcosm of how manipulated and how awful this shit is. You got blasting revenues. Year over year, same store results, or whatever they fucking call it, right? Who knows more than anything? The stock knows. The stock knows. You don't know. There's a guy sitting out there with 3.9 million shares of Yeti who is waiting for this moment to dump it on the people that read Yahoo Finance or who listen to CNBC. Oh, Yeti came out with some good numbers. Oh, maybe I should get some Yeti. Maybe this rallies into Christmas. Well, they do have a dog bowl for $49.99. A dog bowl for $49.99. Oh, you gotta be involved in Yeti. You think I was buying Yeti 4 days ago because I really think it's a viable company with $49.99 fucking dog bowls? Who gives a shit? I don't give a shit. The stock broke out, and that's the end of the story. And then you sold off on the earnings. I'll be back. Oh, man, overly excited. Well, that phone call it comes at a particular time. I don't know if you guys know, but I'm working with some more, I don't know what the word I want to use here, less insane, maybe? Again, guys, you realize, as much as this, I like getting all uppity and having a good time, and I use some bad language from time to time. But when you come to the trading room, you're going to be kind of maybe all upset that it's actually serious. For the first 3 hours of the day, at least, we take trading very serious. And then if we make our day's pay, and then we get to goof around, have some fun. But again, remember, listen, people, it's the end of the month. If you come in today, you get the rest of the year for free on me. So if you're looking for something to do for the rest of the year, maybe you want to give yourself a Christmas present. How about hanging with the Warlock for the next 2 or 3 weeks? And maybe by Christmas, you decide you want to spend the rest of your life with me and my crew. It'd be a nice setup. So come on in. It's free. Just email me, info@hitthebid.com or Kenny Glick at AOL if you want to use my funny email address, but info@hitthebid.com. Either I'll respond to you or the Grateful Servant. And see, as we're trading here live, this PCG trade is sucking wind. But luckily, we got stopped out at most of it, and yeah, whatever. You tend to lose money on certain trades. By the way, if there's anybody out there, and I've said this a million times, that perpetrates the lie that everything they do is right, come on. Come on. I mean, and me included. I mean, look at some of my beautiful, you know, investments in swing trades that I had on. I mean, the list is nasty at this point. Alibaba should have been 250 by now, right? Stock went to 131. I almost lost my home. How about that Yext? That was really nice, right? I'm in at 15, 17, 50, 20, 22, 50, 25, loading up at 25. It goes to 27, I'm buying more. Thinking 35, 40, I'm dumping it all at 22, 50, and 20, getting lit the fuck up. But at least I didn't get destroyed. I mean, I was in the stock cheaper, same thing with Alibaba. How about that Amarin? 12, 50, 15, 17, 50, 20. Thank God I'm not the guy that sits there and lets myself be a victim anymore. If your stock's going down, you don't have to sit there and stare at it like watching Blue Star Airlines or Teldar Paper or that other Terrafly bullshit, and they're all watching it. I'm like, why aren't you selling it? Sell it. Sell it. Buy it back cheaper. That's trading. You don't have to sit there and watch your freaking money disappear. Just dump it. What's the fear?
That you sell it and then it starts to go back up without you?
So if it does, buy it back. But don't let shit go sideways. Look where U.S. Steel is now. How many times did I think that stock was ready to blast off to 50? I mean, that stock has eaten me alive. Three times I thought that thing was headed to 50, and both times it went down 20-30%. And this time makes no sense at all. But that's right. It's never going to make sense. Because you got everything in place that U.S. Steel was going to blow, was going to accelerate, right? The government was telling you, U.S. Steel, buy it. Even Trump said, we're going to save U.S. Steel. And since that speech, the stock's down, what, 40%? You're never going to make complete sense out of this. But the one thing that does make sense is that UVXY is a stock that just does not want to die right now. And that's telling you that this market is still weak, even though we've had a 600-point move yesterday. 600-point moves don't happen in healthy markets. They don't. Usually it's a short squeeze met with the fear of missing out, missing into a short squeeze, and that's how you get a 600-point move over a depressed market. It's not a healthy move. Healthy now would be the market going sideways for 3 or 4 days, consolidating, and then breaking out again. All right? Anyway, none of that matters because none of you guys are money managers. You're not investing your life savings. We're talking about trading now. Getting into the PCG at 27.20. Getting more at 27.35, selling some at 27.50, selling some at 27.40, and then watching the rest of it go to shit. But at least we made money on this trade, and now we're in a little bit, you know, we had the Yeti overnight. You sold it at the open. You shorted some of it. You made some money on the downside. We even played a bounce at 16.50, and now we don't give a shit about Yeti. Don't give a shit about Amarin anymore. Could give a shit about U.S. Steel, except for the fact that I just bought some at 23. Wait, hang on. I'm up 80 bucks. Ooh, 90 bucks now. Ooh, 10 bucks. 100 bucks. And that's me on the offer. 23.10. Sold. Now I'm on the offer 23.11, sold, 23.12, sold. And there's 120 bucks for me right there on a nice $23 break on U.S. Steel. Right before your very eyes. And that's what I do. I buy U.S. Steel 1,000 shares at 23 bucks and I sell it at 23.10, 11, and 12, and I make myself $100. And now I don't give a shit about U.S. Steel. And if it pulls back tomorrow, I'll do this trade again. Give me some U.S. Steel back at 22.50 and I'm loving it. But right now I'm out, right there, biggity bang bang. All right, there's so much to talk about. Why don't you come into the show and listen to us rant and rave all day, because we are legitimately kicking the shit out of the market right now. Liquidity is king. We come in every day, just look at the things to do. With no responsibility, no positions, nothing to worry about except what's happening right before our very eyes. And I think that's the way to go, and that's the way I'm going to remain. I am the Warlock, and you're not.